Hey there, I'm Ruth Sherman. I'm a CEO and celebrity speech and media coach, but you don't have to be famous to work with me. I have had a full winter of doing a lot of presentations. Now, at these events, it is customary for attendees to stand up and introduce themselves, to give their elevator pitch, their 30-second introductory pitch. And I have been just astonished at how weak, I would say, over 90% of the people are. They just don't look like they want to be there. They don't look like they're enjoying themselves. They don't look believable. So here's the thing. If you want people to gravitate to you, if you have an opportunity to stand in a room in front of a group of people whom you may not be meeting otherwise, frankly, this is a room full of potential clients and you're not making the most of it, you are leaving money on the table, and we don't want you to do that. So here are some tips about how to make a very good, a very solid introductory or elevator pitch that takes you up in your elevator instead of down. Number one, you want to know what you're going to say. So for example, I say, hi, I'm Ruth Sherman. I'm a CEO and celebrity speech and media coach, but you don't have to be famous to work with me. Now look, not everybody has the word celebrity in their tag, and but you can all do something. You can all do something. If you're a doctor, you might want to say, I help people live healthy, active lives so they can live a much longer time than they would otherwise. That is an honest way to say what you do and to say it in a way that really tells people what you're after in terms of helping them making their lives better. Second, you have to speak with a strong voice. If you speak with too quiet a voice and it sounds like this and it doesn't sound sure, or if you speak with uptalk and everything is at the end, it comes up like a question, or it's nasal and it doesn't sound sure, it sounds too young and immature, people aren't going to believe you. You need to speak with passion and energy. So let your voice go. Make sure that you're speaking again with passion and energy. Remember when your parents or your teacher said to say it like you mean it? Say it like you mean it. Third, you want to stand tall. You want to put your shoulders back. Your posture has to be good. Use your hands. It should create an open posture so that indicates that you are accessible, that you're looking forward to meeting people. It tells people that you are, again, there for them, and they'll want to come to you. Fourth, you want to make sure that you make eye contact with people in the room. Don't look down. Don't look off to the side. Don't look above somebody's eyes. Look at them right in the eye. You communicate so well with people, it really builds so much rapport. And smile. You've got to look like you're enjoying yourself, even if you're not. Because I will tell you this, if you look like you'd rather be elsewhere, people will go elsewhere.